Today we're having our leader Sri Pradeep Bradhwaj Ji, Honorable MP, Member of Parliament, and AICC Observer Manipur, and also one time ministers in the Assam. You will be having this press conference today. The important point of today's press conference will be on drug management in Manipur and India. Sir, please, it's getting on.
Good morning. Today, you see, I have come here in presence of our PCC president, the working presidents, and a very distinguished leaders of the Congress Party in Manipur. You all know that in India, wherever the BJP government is in power, whether it's in Delhi, whether it's in Assam, or it's in Manipur, are left high and dry. All those problems which really touch the lives of the common people have been ignored. But on the contrary, certain things are happening in the country. They are not only scuttling and throttling the democracy of the country, they are not only intimidating the dissents, the protests, the voices of the common people, they are also patronizing certain things which really is a very bad omen for the country's future, especially for the new generations. The Congress Party is very concerned. We all know very recently on the 13th September, in the Adani Mundra port of Gujarat, 3,000 kgs of heroin contraband has been detected, worth 21,000 crores. And this entire heroin apparently was being brought to India from Afghanistan through Iran by a particular company called ASI Trading Company. The question arises, why Adani Port? Why this contraband, those people who are behind this contraband and bringing this huge quantum of heroin, why did they find Adani Port to be a safe haven? This is not the first time. In this year itself, in the month of June, another unprecedented quantum of heroin was brought into India, which has come to light in the month of June. 25,000 kgs of heroin, worth 1,75,000 crores. And all these heroin apparently were brought, exported from Afghanistan as a semi-cup telecom powder. It has been detected now. Imagine all these contrabands, heroin, and illegal drugs have been brought to India in a very organized manner. In the month of June, this 1,75,000 crores worth of contraband, 25,000 kgs of heroin, was brought to India by the same company. But the police, the agencies, the security forces could not detect them. They just vanished into the thin air. Why the Congress Party is concerned? that this kind of social manas has been promoted, encouraged and organized under the present BJP government. Why is it not that the agencies like CBI, Enforcement Directorate, or Narcotics Control Bureau, or other agencies have not been able to contain it or nip in the bud, whereas they are being used against opposition politicians, the opposition parties, any voice that is against the present government? And this drug menace, which is growing during the times of BJP rule, whether it's in center or whether it's in the state, is a very dangerous thing and it is killing our future. I would like to point out that wherever the BJP governments are in power, take the example of Manipur. It is now reported that for last 5 years, this drug menace, especially the movement, illegal import and movement of drugs, has been intensified under the patronage of the BJP government. I would like to give you an example. In 2019, you are all aware that in the neighboring Thoval district, a drug called World Is Yours, WI tablets, worth 400 crores was confiscated in 2019. Recently, the government of Assam has mounted an operation against the contraband, the drugs that is getting prevalent among the youths. And in Assam, in many places, in last 1.5 months, police has caught many drug peddlers, drug suppliers and distributors, and most of them on interrogation have confessed that the drugs have gone from Manipur to state to Assam and other parts of the Northeast, maybe beyond Northeast also. I am pointing out is not only the Thoval incident where 400 crores worth of contraband and these illegal drugs were accidentally confiscated in Thoval district those days. And you know, few foreigners were also arrested who were from Myanmar along with the local accomplices. But the police department of Manipur failed to build up a watertight case. As a result, all those people who were arrested in Manipur in connection with the confiscation of these drugs were all laid off by the courts, you know that. All these arrested persons were given, they have been released by the court in this year. That shows that there has been absolute laxity on the part of prosecution, on the part of the police department and the government of Manipur, to mount and have a proper political will to stem this drug menace. The Congress party is very concerned. We are just drawing the attention. It's not only the Adani port, it's not only the case of Gujarat. Everywhere, wherever BJP governments are there, like Manipur, the drug menace is growing under the patronage of the BJP government, as in Manipur. Now, you know that Congress party takes very strong measures whenever Congress attains power, the way we did in Punjab. We intend to make it very clear that elections of Manipur are coming. The Congress party is determined to form a government in the elections, assembly elections that are going to be held in just 5 months away from now, 4 to 5 months away. I, as an AICC observer, have come here and joined our Congress family. We are working now, day and night, to strengthen the party, to prepare ourselves, and we are determined that we'll be able to uproot the present corrupt and ineffective government that is in power in Manipur. See, the present government of Manipur has been a total failure. It is alarming that the unemployment in Manipur has risen by many folds. It has grown like a huge colossus. And the Manipur government has tried to suppress the actual fact and data. If you file an RTI application seeking the data of the present unemployment in Manipur, you will not get any data. The present government of Manipur is hiding, trying to hide the fact, trying to suppress the fact that the unemployment has risen in huge proportion in Manipur. Thousands of young men and women are without jobs. People have lost their livelihood support system. They are unemployed in every family. And on the top of it, corruption is getting rampant in every sphere of government. The level of corruption has grown in an alarming manner. There has been total lack of development in Manipur. Whatever tangible development, whether roads or buildings, whether the new secretariat building, the assembly building, the high court, everything that you see in the skyline of Imphal, everything was done during the time of the Congress government that we had in Manipur before 2017. The law and order, I need not say, because it is very clear. The law and order situation has deteriorated in such a way that there is always a sense of fear, a sense of anxiety among the people, though because of the very sustained effort of Ibobi government, the conflict resolution was initiated. After long time, Ibobi government, the Congress government, brought in peace. People heaved a sigh of relief. But after that, Manipur's situation has not improved. The glaring example is the incident of the brutal killing of this leader, you know, late Athwan Evanmai. He was killed in the broad daylight. And all this must have happened because of the laxity, because of the failure of the present government of Manipur. The Congress Party condemns the killing of the public leader, late Athwan Evanmai. We are demanding that the culprits, or if any organization is involved, they should be brought to justice. And here we see the role of the central government is totally nil. They have not stepped in at a time when the state government has failed. So we demand that the culprits of the killing, the brutal killing of late Athwan Evanmai, should be nabbed, should be arrested, and they should be brought to justice. Having said all these, in the forthcoming elections, the Congress Party has already made arrangements. We are taking all measures and we are raring to fight BJP and bring in new aspirations, hope, and another era of peace and development in Manipur. This is the resolve that Congress Party has made. And towards the preparation of the elections, the Congress Party has taken various measures. All the election committees, different committees, to run elections, to campaign, and to go to every nook and corner of the state. We are all getting ready, and I'm sure the people of Manipur will repose their faith in the Congress Party once again. So this is what our request to the people of Manipur, that Congress Party is never going to let down the people of Manipur. We will make all efforts. We will all be together, united, and we will see to it the hope and aspirations of the Manipuri people, the young generations, people, whether one is staying in the hills or whether one is staying in the plains. The Congress Party is taking up all measures, and we will give protection, we will give security, and most of all, we will work for the overall development of Manipur. Thank you.
Sir, government is approaching the Ministry of Home Affairs to investigate the issue by an agency like NIA.
But I say that this is a time that government agencies, the central government agencies, should also step in. Because we know that central agencies also have been working in Manipur. So why not? Why are they are showing such complacency now? And you all know that it had been a very long-drawn process of conflict resolution, all initiated, augmented, and carried out by the Congress government. Today, if there is peace in Manipur, that is because of a very sustained effort of the Congress government that we had in Manipur. So that is why we are very apprehensive that this era of peace that Congress government brought into Manipur, probably the present BJP or the forces supported by BJP are trying to bring in this era of this instability. So obviously, we want, whether it's a central agency, whether it's a NIA or CBI or any agency, because there's a total failure. Yeah. So they should be brought in. We want the culprit should be met. That's it. We are, you will see our manifesto is coming for the elections. And we will definitely, drugs issue is one of the major issues because we are very concerned. Because you know, it's very unfortunate, I just want to point out, in the entire country, Manipur is one state where largest number of drug addicts and AIDS infected young men and women are here in Manipur. This is not one issue that we can boast of really. But why is it happening? It's very clear because survey has revealed that these AIDS cases that we have, that is the largest number of cases that we have in Manipur, that's because of intravenous drugs infusion.
Sir, can you highlight some strides you've taken up by the Congress so far?
Of course, we are very concerned and we will take up measures and that will be very clearly spelled out in our manifesto.
Probability of
any is working day and night to strengthen the party. We are trying to enthuse our grassroots level workers. We are going to all the polling stations. You know, we are setting up, we are strengthening our grassroots level committees, the unit committees. And then we are very confident of fighting elections on our own. But party will decide. Because if it's in the interest of Manipur for bringing in peace and stability and an era of development, Congress party is an open mind. But obviously, Congress party is in a position to fight election on its own as of now. Try to have and try to strengthen the anti-BJP forces because we want to uproot the BJP because of their misrule from Manipur. We will cross the bridge when it comes, but as of now, we are ready to fight elections on our own.